right. Thank you. Thank you, Sune, for the invitation. I'm really glad to be here. So yeah, we talk about cohomology with twisted coefficient of linking system and the link with some kind of stable elements. So let me give you a bit of motivation. And I guess the first result I should mention is the result of Carton and Eilenberg, which tells you that if you have a finite group G, any G module, I should say ZP of G module, then if you look at the restriction to the CLOP subgroup of G, then this map is injective. And is the image is actually all the element in the cohomology of S which are stable in the sense that, so if I take phi, I take a subgroup in S and G in G with B to the G again in S, then I have some diagram like that. So here I have restrictions, and here I have map induced by conjugation. And so I want that when I take x there and then there, it's the same as sending it there. So the restriction from P to G to S of x is C star of G. Take the restriction from S to P G of X. All right. So some notion of stable by the action of a fusion of what we call the transporter system. S of G. So you can write it as a inverse limit, and here. TS of G, I'm not sure you have seen, I guess you have seen it this week. So the object are the subgroup of S and the morphism are what I denote TG PQ, which is all the element which conjugate P into Q. Okay, don't forget that we start at 2 this afternoon. And so if you, for example, require that, don't forget you, so we start at 2 this afternoon. Thanks. So if M is the action and M is trivial, then actually you can see that this functor factor through the fusion system, and so you end up with the limit over the fusion system of a cohomology functor. All right, and then well, we're dealing with fusion system. There is a theorem of Brotteau, Levy, and Oliver, which tells you that if you take the geometric realization of a linking system with, so actually I should say BLO and BCGLO, Brotteau, Castellana, Godard, Levy, Oliver, And if I take M to be any Z P module, so BLO is for M equal FP, and in BCGLO you can find a generalization for any ZP module. So this is actually a limit over the fusion system of Comor G functor. Right, so it's somehow the same kind of result as this one, but for the geometrialization of a linking system. So when you think as the linking system as a locality, in fact, the locality is somehow what should replace the group here. So it's mostly the same result that you're getting here. Right.
I have a question.
Yeah.
Is it enough to have that so take the group the subgroup of G generated by all the centralizers of the elementary abelian P subgroups in a pseudo group? Sometimes that's proper. So is that
so
is it enough to have that act trivially?
Yeah.
Okay.
Definitely, yeah. Yeah, you just need to be sure that the centralizer acts trivially in a way that here you can caution by the centralizer. That's true. All right. All right. So now the question is, so this result is true for any coefficient with an action of G. So can we have sort of the same kind of result for here, instead of taking a trivial action, you have an action of a fundamental group of a linking system. So, what about a twisted coefficient? So you take M ZP, what I will denote P index in this L, which is pi 1 of the geometrification of L. So if you take module with an action of a fundamental group, can we have something like that the commergy of the geometricalization of L with coefficient in M inject into the commergy of a pseudo P subgroup with the same coefficient and will be made some stable element. So actually, so Levy and Ragnarsson start to study a bit cohomology of linking system with twisted coefficient, actually a bit more general instead of just an action of a fundamental group. They put here any system of coefficient. And in their paper, they actually say that this is not true in general. We cannot expect that in general. So, no, in general. And thing is, so I think yeah, in the paper they mentioned that it's Bob who came up first with the idea. So yeah, so Bob's help. I didn't say anything that. So yeah, so what they prove is that they give condition where this guy can be trivial in higher degree. And sorry, non-trivial in non-zero degree. But if you look at the cohomology of the silo, this is trivial in non-zero degree. So there is definitely no way to send this guy injectively into the cohomology of a pseudo. And this is mostly based on the fact that if you look at the universal covering space of the linking system, it might not be contractible. So I studied when we can expect to have still a formula where this corresponds to some notion of stable elements. So let me first tell you what I mean by stable elements in a context of twisted coefficients. All right. So, it's not that much complicated. So you just need that if you look at pi one of the linking system, you just need that the C Lopez group E included in it, and that the universal curving space of L is non-contractible, or I mean that is non-FP acyclic. And then you just take M to be the free module or projective module, in a way that when you look at this guy, you actually get back to the universal covering space, which is non-trivial in high degree because it's not FP acyclic. But since this guy is pi one of L projective, it will be S projective, and so you have your problem. All right, so.
Is that a case where this pi one is finite?
I'm not sure you need pi one to be finite for that.
But then the coefficients would be infinitely generated, but then you don't care about that.
So to be sure that this is S projective, you need finitely generated? I'm not sure.
Okay, but then I guess in the counterexample would be the infinitely generated coefficient, which is.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
but I mean, you can also require that this is finite, which happens in some cases. For example, for a group of Lie type with a rank bigger than 4, something. I mean, maybe 3 is enough. Yeah, 3 is enough.
But so, yeah.
So for example, yeah, so mostly the example is a group of Lie type with rank higher than 3. Yeah, that's true. Yeah. If you are not in a finite group, yeah, that's true. But S, yeah, that's true. Yeah, that's true. Anyway, so I need to give you a notion of stable elements if I want to talk about stable elements. So let me maybe remind you slightly what is a linking system. In a way that I can put the notation. So it's a linking system come with two functors. So here I'm restricted to the F-centric subgroups, here also to the F-centric subgroups. So this is the transporter category of S over S. So morphisms are, so objects are the F-centric subgroups and morphisms are the element of G. So if I look at morphism from P to Q here, this will be, so all the G in S which sounds P G into Q, right? Okay, I can maybe tell you a bit what these functors are doing. So if you take an object here, it's getting to itself and it's getting to itself, so it's the same. It's the identity on object, and on morphism, I can maybe just give you what's happening on automorphism. So the NS of P injects into, which I will usually not delta P. So this is the injection given by delta into alt L of P, and then this subject onto alt F of P. And the kernel is actually delta P of the center. Okay? Which is mostly what I will need. Whoops. Okay, so. So if you remember in Carton Heilenberg theorem, I'm looking at that as a functor from the transporter category to the two modules. So I can here the idea would be to construct a functor from the linking system instead of the transporter system to ZP mod. So I would define it an object. So an object, you want to get the cohomology of P with M with a coefficient in M. So you need an action of P on M. But the idea is that if you look at S, it's the normalizer in S of S, which injects through delta S to root L of S. And here you have something which goes to pi L. So here omega is defined from L to pi L, which is, remind you, pi 1 of L. And the idea is if you take a morphism here, so you send every object, yeah, I should take capital B. So here what I mean is the category where you have one point and automorphism is a group, okay, a category. So seeing the group as a category. And here, if I take a morphism, I send it to, so here I have S. So the loop given by this, B, B, phi. Okay, where here you just take the, what should play the role of inclusion in the transporter system or the of a linking system. So delta of one, so if I want to be choose PS and P phi S of one. So here this give you a loop in the geometric realization of L. And so for every morphism you send it to a loop, and this is actually a functor. Okay, so it give you morphism of group from S into the pi of L. So you have an action of S, so you have an action of any subgroup of S on M. All right. All right, so, yeah. So on object, you have cohomology of P with M with coefficient in M. All right. And on morphism. So here you use the fact that group cohomology is a bifunctor. And you define, so phi goes from P to Q in the linking system. So that will be defined as the morphism induced by, so you look at, on the groups, you want the morphism of groups induced by phi. Okay, remember that you have phi is the morphism, is the functor which goes from L to the fusion system. So this is an homomorphism of group. And on the module, you want to look at the action of phi seen as an element of the fundamental group. Okay? And this, so, yeah, so the action of this guy. And this is well defined using there is an axiom in a linking system which tells you that, so if you have so if you here you look at the action of, so if you take P in P, then here in the linking system, this is, you have a commutative diagram like that, maybe not take B, let's take H to avoid any H, for any H in P. And this tells you that this is well defined and you can apply the cohomology functor on it. Okay? All right. So you mean what I'm doing here? Yeah, so I mean here what I'm meaning by that, I'm looking at the loop given by the edge given by this map, the edge given by this map, and the edge given by this map. So this gives me a loop. Yeah. So the base point is the S. So yeah. Bar one of L S. Okay. All right. Yeah. That's a way to another way to do so. Yeah, you can start from L and then you do some kind of groupoid completion, universe every morphism, and then you go to the fundamental group. This is a more abstract way to do it, actually. All right. So you have defined you have a functor which goes from L to ZP mod. And now it's no more on the board. No, it's on the board. Remember that the kernel of this map is the center of P. Okay? And when you look at how the center of P is acting, it's actually acting as it should acting, as it should act. So as P is not acting on its cohomology, actually this functor factor through the centric Park coefficient system. So here I would put the same functor. And so now I can consider stable elements as the limit over the centric part of the fusion system of this guy. Of this guy, this functor there. Okay? And so I can factor because ZP, which is a subgroup of P, acts trivially on one remark, of course, if the action of an M is trivial, then this is exactly the same as the mark if the action is trivial, then the limit on the fusion system of this functor is actually the same, or actually equal to the cohomology. Limit over the centric part of the cohomology functor, and this is by Alperin fusion's theorem. Which tells you that any morphism in the fusion system can be written as a composite of restriction of automorphism of centric subgroups. It's a bit more precise by that, but it's just what I need here. Okay? So to be stable under the centric part is enough to be stable under the whole fusion system. So this generalizes the notion of stable element in the trivial case. Okay. Another remark, because so you may want to but maybe we can just extend this functor to the whole fusion system and then get back to that. The thing is, you cannot extend this functor to the whole fusion system. And so, I mean, it's the idea the idea behind it is, so if you just have to look at the trivial subgroup, actually. So this tells you that you cannot at least go to the trivial subgroup. So this cannot be extended to F. So yeah, if you look at, so you may want to look at, if it was the case, then you can look at the trivial subgroup. Yep. Which give you, in degree zero, which give you M, okay? In the fusion system, so if I look at something like that, so this diagram should commute, okay, because it commutes in the fusion system. So, but the thing is, here you have M. So mostly what you're saying is that phi is acting trivially on M. Okay, so you need M to be trivial in order to be able to extend to the whole fusion system. And this is actually a bit, this gives you a lot of trouble when you want to deal with characteristic biset and stuff. So, all right, where am I? Here. Yeah, so now, what condition do we need to get right, so what kind of condition we can look at where this might be true? So the first thing we can do is look at easy fusion system. And the one I looked at was when F is constrained. So which means that OP of F, so the maximal P subgroup which is normal in F, is centric. This case is easy because we have a good description of the homotopy type of the linking system. So in that case, we have that the homotopy of the linking system is, I think it's BCGLO again, to the classifying space of a group, or a finite group, which realizes the fusion system. And even more, you have OP of G is centric. So CG of OP of G is subgroup of OP of G. So this is a very particular group, which is really nice to work with. So here you have that the cohomology of L with coefficient in M is actually the cohomology of G with coefficient in M. So now we have to compare that with the stable elements. Okay? But in that case, so if you look at a transporter system where you take all the subgroup above G, okay, this is a good retract of a transporter system. And you have at the limit over this OP of G of actually any functor, you don't need to get as the limit over the transporter system, the whole transporter system. And since this group is centric, this part is contained in the centric part of the linking system.